Good morning, good morning, good morning. Happy Sabbath to all of you. This is Chef Dagger Rastafari coming to you. And I'm doing this video for a certain friend of mine. Soul God 74, this is for you. This is Godzilla, by the way. I got so many cuttings off this tree.
Help us now. Take us from
soul some.
Never give up at the world. Strictly find your bun.
Help us planet now. Some.
Take us from the slum.
Never
give up at the world. It's a lassie. I'm blessed. Separation is a
thing.
We need a harder time. Got to widen your views. Got to broaden your mind. What we find in the ghetto, nowhere else can you find. Hunger, poverty, assist us all mankind. As a matter of fact, there is an aftershock. When come ground up my bed, and my pillow was a rock. Trying to make it through the system, all the doors were locked. Yet nothing me to try, and so I ain't gon' stop. All the time they write a book on you. All sorts of other crap they would have put on you. Yet when you're in the dirt, they would look on you. They would only stand and wanna wipe the foot on you. But so see ya,
this one is another
Sun's
tree.
Hey,
Manala, Jomie, watch what happens. I have another one right here. Trees that was right here beside my brand new stuff. I dug it out. I had a Pakistan mulberry right here, if you remember, dug it out and put it in my compost bin. Now I put my calamondin tree right here. You know, I left it in the pot though, and I cut like a X in the bottom, put down some wood chips and manure with some 646 fertilizer and also some Linda 511. There you have it. Old Granny Smith looking real nice. I gotta water it. Nice mangoes. More mangoes, y'all. More mangoes. This is my compost bin, y'all. Before, you know, I used to let them pick it up actually today, you know, and the recycling man actually came and knocked on my door and said, "You're not gonna put the green one out?" I said, "Oh no, not no more." See, that's a young Pakistan mulberry that I chopped down, using it for compost. Let's look at my lime tree back here. Thinking of moving it, but I'm not really sure. Should I move it? Should I leave it alone? You know? I mean, it's looking quite nice. You know what I'm saying? Other from, like, let me zoom in a little bit on that. Try to get it. It got like some ants crawling on the leaves. I don't know if y'all can see that. Yeah. And it had some like leaf discoloration. What another fellow gardener / subscriber, you should go check her channel out too. Cheryl Organic Food Forest over there in Texas. She has some great content, man. I put some manure and wood chips around here too, if you could see. Yep. Give me 1 second, everybody. Let me close this back gate real quick. Give me 1 second, y'all. Well, I'll do it a little bit later. Move on in the video. My passion fruit vine that's growing up in the tree. And it has fruit, but, you know, I have to like go hunting for them in this mango tree here. And slowly but surely, mango season is coming to an end in my yard. You know. I had so much mangoes, man, it was ridiculous. Tomato tree that just, I don't really like tomatoes from, you know, like fast food restaurants. I take them off my sandwiches and, you know, throw them down in the pot. That's what happened. I'm I'm probably gonna like dig it up and plant some more because it ain't really doing nothing for me. There you have it. Oh, show y'all the plum tree again. That's a methylene plum. I ordered a, you call it a fruit cocktail orchard. Bears like 6 different kinds of fruit, you know, apricot, nectarine, 3 kind of plums that should be coming hopefully soon. This is a plum tree, another plum tree that I propagated. Us islanders call this hog plum. See it here? That's all new growth down there. I don't know if y'all could get a better focus. That's all new growth right there. Here's my fig tree, y'all. You know, I keep it like watered and giving y'all the showing y'all an update. The one that I had in the pot, I sold it. Someone hit me up on my marketplace app postings and they're like, I gotta have it. I said, okay, come get it. It's yours. You know what I mean? That's how I make my little extra money on the side, just like my homie Lead Farmer 73. Also, y'all should go check him out. He got some stuff going on, boy. And yes, I was like inspired by him, you know what I mean? Lead Farmer 73 made me do it. Yeah. All right, let me go back to doing what I was doing before I started the video. This is my East Indian mango tree, looking real nice, getting tall, a little bit too tall. Probably gonna have to like start pruning it back. I planted, this tree is like about 2 years old. And I planted it from seed. I'm 6'5" and a half, you know, 6'6". See? I'm about 6'5", 6'6". Okay? And if you could see, this tree is damn near twice as tall as I am. Let me get like another angle. Even the limbs that's from the bark of the tree, it's almost taller than I am. And I love how thick this bark is. my good friend right here, my very good friend, that Linda 511, that old stinky stink. All right, let me get back to doing what I originally came outside to do. Here you go. Some wood chips and manure. And I'm finna, you see how tall this is? I'm finna chop it down. Cut it down to like right here. All right, y'all have a blessed one. And thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Really appreciate it. God bless.